Welcome. I'm going to discuss here the use of constraint-based programming and control for advanced sensor-based applications and for applications that involve human interaction. Hopefully, this presentation will show that constraint-based programming is not only useful for programming complex high degree of freedom robot systems, such as humanoids, but it's also useful for more standard industrial robot manipulators and tasks. In the course of this presentation, I will explain to you our task specification control framework ETADL, and I will show you how it can be used in a number of industrial applications in tasks that involve complex sensor interactions and human-robot interaction. Traditionally, robots are used in very conditioned environments where the location of every object is very well known. Cages protect the human operators, but also ensure that there is no or only a few disturbances that can influence the robot task. However, our ambition goes clearly beyond that. We want to apply robotics for smaller series in, for example, small enterprises. In these environments, it's difficult to completely separate the robot cell from the rest of the production line using a cage. More flexibility is needed. Objects are often not accurately placed by human workers. Humans are often operating much closer to the robot, and sometimes humans are even directly interacting with the robots. So, we have two seemingly contradicting goals. On one hand, we have to be robust against many types of variations, such as not accurately placed workpieces or workpieces with shape variations, such as natural products or uncertainty in production processes, such as casting. Also, the human can interfere with the process by, for example, occupying the workspace, and for some tasks, it can be even useful to directly interact with a human co-worker. To achieve robustness against these variations, reactive, sensor-based control is needed. This, of course, leads to more complex and involved robot programs. On the other hand, we want to apply these applications in smaller enterprises, for smaller series, so we want to decrease the development cost. These are, of course, conflicting goals. However, we think that constraint-based programming can partially resolve this.